But a fantastic Mawashi getting roundhouse kick on him. Oh, and Galvao tagged him as well. They clinch up for the first time.
De Ritter usually has his way with people on the ground, and Galvao was able to defend correctly and get back up to his feet. Now he's trying to throw that big overhand right. You can start to see him. Nice little sneaky little shot there from De Ritter as he worked inside.
Oh, big punches coming in from Galvao. Head and body. Oh, huge right hand. Mizuno took with his back to his opponent.
To overcome the massive height and reach differential.
A lot of times when you get two high-level grapplers, such as we have here, it comes down to striking.
Seen it before, that all that muscle just sucks the oxygen out of your body, and it can fatigue you really fast.
Oh, big left hand after he threw a right as well.
Especially when you have those grappling exchanges, but those are some big paws.
Oh, another big one.
Both these guys want to stay on top. That's where this match is going to be decided. Who can avoid the bottom position?
Gilberto Galvao resumes action with Tatsuya Mizuno as Anthony Suntai calls for noise in this arena. It's barely needed because they're loving this contest.
Galvao trying to gas out his arms, get tired. You know, those big muscles eat up a lot of oxygen, so if Jake can make him work as much as possible in these struggles and these scrambles,
Galvao's kind of rushing in there, and you can just see the fatigue. Galvao's just slowing down a little bit, and the punches are starting to come really wide.
Looking for some ground and pound here as the Brazilian from half-guard position, dropping the elbows.
He's not blinking hard, though. There was a punch landed around the eye, whether a finger was stray or not. Again, perhaps we'll see in a replay. You get the impression that Galvao's looking for every little piece of respite he can.
Between Galvao and a beautiful two-punch combination down the center corridor there for Gilberto Galvao.
Conditioning to perform the best they can.
Mizuno looks nice and light. He still looks fresh.
Oh, right hand was so solid. And again, he's complaining about a low blow.
Actually was looking down, you'll see it here.
All right,
and I was gonna say that I can hear the sound of a cup. Listen, this is a bad foul here. As I'm looking at Galvao in the cage, I'm not 100% he's gonna recover from this. So in this case, if he doesn't return to the fight, I don't believe we're at the midpoint yet. I didn't actually check the clock, but
I doubt it.
Yeah, I don't think we're at the midpoint of the fight.
Yeah, that was a lengthy break for him to get his, good right hand. He followed it up with a left.
That connected well, Steve. That was a beautifully timed right hand thrown by Galvao.
Galvao still looking to just come inside and land a big right and a left. And that rocked Mizuno, no question. See?
Yeah, he rushes forward because he's at a reach disadvantage. And there's a big clubbing right hand that clipped the top of Mizuno's head.
That's really the only punch he's going for. The left is nothing more than a rangefinder maybe at the moment. He's just looking to land that right, and there it is, and it followed up with the left, and they were clean punches high to the head, and Mizuno took those very well. We've seen that several times, but he's reducing the chances of a big finish. With every second that goes by, although as I say that, a big right hand again lands hard. In comes Galvao with that big swinging right hand. This time he lands. But will Mizuno fire off more of these kicks?
Hold your shorts.
Good defense by Mizuno as he circles away from the cage. Well done. But his accuracy has improved. The final 4 minutes of that round, he was a lot crisper with a lot of his strikes.
Oh, left, right, left. A knee to the body from Mizuno. Right and left, not clean blows from Galvao this time.